Judith visits the beautiful villages of Langweer and Sloten, but she begins her tour in Amsterdam.
This is Rozengracht, one of the main streets in the old city of Amsterdam. Unmistakably continental, it's nothing to send postcards home about. A sort of Main Street Europe, which might be anywhere in any one of half a dozen countries. But then, 90 years ago, they filled in the canal that ran down the middle of Rozengracht. And it's the canals that make Amsterdam magical. The canals were dug in Holland's golden age in the 17th century. Then the Dutch East India Company made Holland one of the richest nations in the world, and its merchants moguls in their own right. They built their homes shoulder to shoulder along the canal banks. As they were taxed on their frontages, they built their houses narrow. And as that meant their staircases were narrow too, they built cranes in the roof to hoist goods up to the storerooms on the top floor. There were no house numbers in those days, so you remembered where your friends lived by the shape of their gables. One problem the merchants didn't have was finding a place to park. Amsterdam is not a city to drive in, although since they line the canals with mini railings, it is now harder to drive into the water. And by the way, the water is said to be so polluted that even the ducks are supposed to be poisonous. It's a town for walking or cycling. After all, the bicycle is almost as Dutch as the clog, and you can hire them at railway stations for about 50 pence a day. If your imagination should be fired to discover what life must have been like behind these elegant facades 300 years ago, you can discover that too. Meticulously detailed models, immaculate down to the button-sized Delft china. Clay pipes as slender as fish bones, the family Bible. Silver and kitchen utensils. Well, this is one of three dolls' houses on display at the Rijksmuseum, Holland's National Gallery, and one of the most famous museums of art in the world. And just as the old city of Amsterdam is perfectly preserved itself, so in some 40 museums it preserves its treasures. And what treasures? This is the most famous picture in the museum, Rembrandt's Night Watch. Rembrandt and his contemporaries were not dependent upon vain patrons. They sold their paintings to people who actually wanted to buy them. And such freedom allowed them to challenge convention and paint new subjects in a new style. Amsterdam is never quite what it seems. It even sells itself on its surprises. This is a town where the kitchen of one hotel is below water, where the cooks look passing boats in the propellers. Where the roadsides are festooned with some of the city's 500,000 bicycles. And the streets vibrated by trams, which still provide the cheapest ride across town. Where you can down a salted herring on the street side. Where you can buy a bunch of tulips from a floating flower shop, or adopt a stray cat from a floating pound. It's still a mecca for international youth who can strum their guitars in Dam Square beneath the gaze of the former palace until the street cleaners move in at 6 o'clock, where they can even smoke marijuana in what was once a reformed church. And then sleep under the stars in Vondel Park. It's a city where the organs still play on the streets. Here in the Leidse Plain is the center of Amsterdam's more respectable nightlife. Elsewhere, it offers a pretty exotic line in adult entertainment. Amsterdam is popular for short holidays, weekends in particular. There are package deals by air, coach and rail. The cost depends on how and when you come, but a summer weekend by air with two nights, bed and breakfast in a reasonable hotel will cost about £60 per person. One dodge for the free and easy is to book a seat with a scheduled airline the day you want to fly. That way, you can get a ticket half price. When you get here, life is not cheap. Here's how the price check breaks down. A cup of coffee will cost you 16 pence, a daily newspaper, 14 pence, an ice cream, 12 pence. A scotch is 33 pence. A reasonable meal is £3.33, and a bottle of wine will cost you a further £3. Better to stick to the beer at 17 pence. But the best things in Amsterdam are free, like discovering this old tasting bar. In the old days, it was where you came to taste drinks before buying them. Today, it specializes in Dutch liqueurs. Here, the locals don't have their personal tankards, but their own barrels of gin and liqueurs. And even now, the customers are expected to bow to tradition. They call this a half and half. Half orange bitters, half Curacao. Amsterdam's the same. Half proper, half bizarre. Or, as a statue in the city centre says, Amsterdam is like a little boy. Naughty, but good at heart.
Tradition is as much a part of Amsterdam as its canals. Go into a brown cafe, one of Amsterdam's pubs, which open every day between 8 o'clock on one morning and 1 o'clock the next. They're called brown simply because they're painted brown, though why, no one now seems certain. You'll be welcomed immediately as a friend, and incidentally, nearly everyone speaks English. Amsterdam has always accepted minorities before anywhere else, and that goes for tourists too. Explore the old town and be surprised by views that have been surprising for three centuries.
Remember too that Amsterdam, like so much of Holland, is man-made on land reclaimed from the sea. God created the universe, but the Dutch made Holland, as the saying goes.